Hello, everyone. My name is Kunal, and I am here to share my experiences at KubeCon EU 2021 as a student. Now, this was my fourth KubeCon overall and my second favorite one. My favorite one by far was the San Diego one in 2019, North America. It was also my first in-person KubeCon, so I met a lot of nice people, and KubeCon in-person events, as we all know, they are something else, so it was one of the best experiences of my life. Speaking of this KubeCon, it was huge in terms of the number of attendees, around 26,000 attendees, and 69% were first-time attendees. So I believe that's pretty impressive. And also so many projects coming in the sandbox stage is also something I feel like was a very good thing. Now, before we get started with all the things KubeCon specific, let me just share my favorite co-located events that I really enjoyed. First and foremost, the Civo launch. Right from the start of the short video clip about how the team worked and assembled the infra to informative hands-on sessions, and it was just a great learning experience even for me, and also a great way to get started with the product for many of the attendees as well. Now, another particular event that I enjoyed was the Data on Kubernetes co-located event. There were some amazing speakers over there, and I spoke at that event as well about scaling communities to be more inclusive. Now, the next one being the Crossplane Community Day Europe Talk by Andy from Civo. I learned about the initial shortcomings that Civo had, with APIs, upgrades, and consistency using OpenStack, and how they formed the Civo Stack hardware using Open Compute Project, and just offering tool-less functionality and increased performance. So that was a pretty insightful talk. Now, one thing that I noticed during this KubeCon was the, as I mentioned earlier as well, 69% first timers, right, attendees. And one thing that I particularly noticed was a lot of students attended this particular KubeCon. And I felt really good because of that, because while this was my fourth KubeCon, I do run a community, and in the community that I have, students are not aware of CNCF, they're not aware of KubeCon and all these events and everything. But one thing what they all have in common is how to get involved. They are really passionate about open source. So I reached out to Bill, and I was like, hey Bill, do you mind if we conduct a session on intro to KubeCon and intro to CNCF and stuff? And Bill was like, yeah, let's do that. So I did, and then I gave away 500 plus tickets to students for free with the help of Bill. So I could definitely see all these students attending even the sessions and sharing on Twitter, meeting us in the hallway tracks and stuff, being active on Slack, taking part in events and all these things. So just shout out to Bill, shout out to the CNCF community for everything that they do to make communities more inclusive for first timers and beginners. While I'm sure all the talks were really good, these are the ones that I particularly found pretty interesting and was inspired by. The first one being, does not need any introduction, The Building Blocks for the Human Experience by Priyanka and Zane, where they gave insights on how CNCF supports diversity and is as inclusive as it can be. I also noticed many students as well, who got a chance to speak or who were ex-CNCF mentees, they also got a chance to, speak at the keynotes as well, and also had many talks. So I believe giving them a platform, irrespective of what the background of that person is, if they have something to share, you have a place in CNCF, right? It's as inclusive as it can be, as I mentioned already. So that is something I saw during the keynotes as well. I believe that was pretty cool. Now, one more talk that I believe everyone enjoyed and were praising on Twitter and other social media handles as well was by Bob and Eva, where they spoke about the Kubernetes community and the scalability of social groups, transparency and accountability, and the values of the community. So it was clearly one of my favorite talks in any particular event, because these particular being an open source and community enthusiast myself, I believe these topics are very, very crucial, and we need to be discussed upon and acted upon as well. And we all know the importance of the important role the documentations play in any particular project. And I always mention one thing you cannot get, one thing a project cannot get enough of is good documentation, right? So This is the reason I particularly enjoyed this talk by Celeste, because not only are docs a great way to create a community to be more inclusive of contributors, but also a big help for the users. So yeah, the talk was about taking your project docs to the next level. And I love the point Celeste made about thinking from a beginner's point of view, thinking about the beginners who are going to be reading your documentation and how new contributors are important for the documentation specifically. Because I also love this point of cherishing your beginner's mindset, because you only get to be a beginner once, and you should not be afraid to ask questions. Because if an experienced person, this is something I have noticed as well, if I'm experienced in a particular thing and I'm writing a blog in that, I will go deep into it without, sometimes you go so much deep into it, you forget what a beginner might be thinking when they're reading this particular thing. But if a beginner is writing that while learning, while contributing, they're writing that from a beginner's point of view. That is much more helpful to another beginner. That was a point that I really, really enjoyed. And as a student, one of the things I love about the CNCF community is how inclusive it is to newcomers. And as a newcomer, not only, not everyone would be familiar with the complex code structure of these various projects. The first time I saw the CNCF landscape photo, it was just like, sort of like, where's Waldo, so many projects, and how to actually, which project to choose, which domain to choose, and all these things. And the thing that I have also realized is that non-code contributions, play a major role in any particular organization. Documentation, for example, is a great way to get involved. This is why I particularly love the path to non-code contribution panel discussion. I've been interacting with this panel as well. I've been contributing to the SIG Contribex, the marketing team. I'm currently a Kubernetes 1.22 release shadow for comps, and this is a talk where I could relate to the most, right? So I was like, yeah, that's pretty interesting. That's exactly what happened with me as well. That's exactly how I got involved in the community as well. And I was also a beginner, and that's how I got involved. And my key takeaways from the panelists, I love the points that Kat mentioned regarding the CNCF, being one of the most social and welcoming communities. So just talk to the community, and they mentioned something regarding I'm just a community member who ended up with a voice. That happened via talking to a lot of people. So talk to us, we would like to have you, and we'll find some stuff for you to work on. And that is exactly what happened with me as well. I remember Castlin gave me a few tasks regarding Twitter and blogs and things like that. So I believe that was great. And yeah, speaking of Castlin's point of views, she mentioned something about contributing to open source, is a really good way of learning in public, which is something I cannot, agree more on, because we all learn from our mistakes and we all work together to make something great. Could not agree more with that. Also, the point Koi mentioned regarding even fixing typos is a valid contribution. I believe I pronounced the name correctly, Koi, if you're watching. So yeah, that was I relate to this, because my first ever open source contribution was in my freshman year, and I was fixing typos. I still fix typos, but not as much as I was doing in freshman, when I first started out. So because as a beginner, it's definitely going to help the documentation as well. And also I got to learn about the Git and GitHub structure of the particular organization. Loved this particular line by Matt, which was, being a beginner is an expertise. And I believe I talked about being a beginner beforehand as well. So yeah, that was about the non-code contributions talk. And one thing I also want to share is that we learn by getting inspired by others and other people when they share their experiences. Especially as a student, I get inspired by all the people, in open source, people I work with, people who are my mentors, and events that I attend, project maintainers, for example, teachers, and all these other seniors, for example. So open source is for everyone, and every contribution counts is something that I personally believe in. Also from my experiences, I found that to be true. And giving people a platform to showcase their journey as a contributor is something I truly believe in. I enjoyed the insightful tips shared by Chris, Castlin, Piyush, and Matt on their talk about how you can share and how you can tell your Kubernetes contributor story. So I believe they gave some pretty insightful tips over there. Now, I personally haven't had much experience with chaos engineering. While building my schedule, I found the perfect talk that I was looking for, power level 9000, and it was about improving application performance with chaos engineering, led by Sayam and Karthik. Now, this was a great way to get introduced to the topic. I learned about like testing versus experimentation, about various tools, and in general, a lot of things. And I believe the From my particular point of view, I believe the goal of these talks, right, is to actually get you started. In just one introductory talk, you are not going to become an expert, but it's more than enough for you to get started, and the resources that they share for you to look it up after the talk is over is what I believe the most important part as well. Yeah, if you learn more about the project, you have to explore. Okay. Now, being a founder of a community myself, I too have struggled with figuring out new ways to create, more awareness about it, to scale the projects that we have created. And we talk about how Cortex went from a vendor project to community by Gotham checked all the boxes for me, because I had heard about it, like Cortex being difficult to use. But some of the key takeaways from the talk really cleared up the points for me and showed how the community is, you know, putting in efforts to. The Cortex community is putting in more efforts to get more people involved. So some key takeaways include like making sure your project is extremely easy to run, and how they are making Cortex simpler to run by reducing the external dependencies by using object storage. Being accessible is one of the most important things. For example, it's important to have regular community calls at least once a month. Most of the open source projects that I have been a part of, who are focusing on, you know, like good open source practices, all have regular community calls. Even at Civo, we have like weekly meetings and stand-ups and all these things. Now, speaking of like tools being used, so Google Group mailing list is good for persistent answers, because if someone is searching for a particular answer that was already answered before, in Slack it can be a little difficult to find, but in Google Group mailing list sort of thing, it's good for like persistent answers that many people might ask over the time. And when a project is first starting out, it's important to have a sync chat like system, like Slack. So yeah, that was also a pretty good point. I also remember many people who obviously definitely would remember when I first saw Dim's tweet about getting rid of Docker shim and pod security policies. Although I didn't freak out, because I did my research and I saw like what it actually was and everything. Many people on social media did. I would highly recommend the talk by Kat and Ian on how to prevent communication breakdowns, where they discuss more about it. And here you can learn more about how these changes were communicated and how to do it better. Now, especially for students, and not just for students, but also someone who is new to CNCF and new to projects and want to get involved, there was a session on College to Cloud Native. And I personally have been a part of like the CNCF mentorship programs as well in 2020. And it was one of the best experiences that you can have to get involved in the community. And I've also like, there was also this like this talk, right, on College to Cloud Native, focused on CNCF internships, right, with like LFX mentorship programs. So if you're a beginner who wants to get involved, check out the mentoring repository on CNCF organization. Over there, you can find many programs you can apply to, like Google Summer Code, Season of Docs, Outreachy, Cross, LFX, so on and so forth. So please do check that out. And there's also like I mentioned it already, the SIG release program, the shadow program. So do check that out as well. It's a great way to get involved and learn while getting mentored. Cool. Just a few other shout outs I want to give to a lot of, the talks that I really found interesting. One was the When Prometheus Cannot Take the Load Anymore by Liron. And they discussed about like M3 versus Thanos versus Cortex, and what are like the differences, how they solve the limitations and all these things. So I believe that was a pretty insightful talk. And one of the best talks that I have ever seen was Hacking into Kubernetes Security for Beginners by Alan and Tabitha. And not just me, I could see like a lot of praise on Twitter for this particular session as well. So yeah, it was a great one. Now, I also want to give a shout out to like the Linux Foundation Public Health and the work they are doing to improve health through open source for COVID-19 and future epidemics as well. And there were a lot of talks and like a lot of things taken away from the keynote. Those were like the highlights for me. But not just that, I believe one of the key parts of these events is the networking, right? So the Slack channel was pretty active. There was a bug bash event I saw. There was a peer group mentoring session that I was a part of. And a lot of students, again, particularly joined and asked their questions. I met a lot of nice people over there as well. So shout out to everyone who mentored and shout out to all the people, you know, who joined. If you're like a beginner and you know, you want to get mentored regarding, there were like basically tracks related to like career, and you could ask about career, you can ask about like technical advice, you can ask about community related stuff, you know, so all these things. So mentoring session I believe was pretty good. One more of the highlights were the Cloud Native TV wrap-up videos. I was also a part of a panel with Anais and Tiffany, and including in many other people. So yeah, check out cloudnative.tv. It was like a great experience, and just like, you know, sharing my my views of the particular event, and also after every day, basically at the end, Cloud Native TV hosted wrap-up shows. So that was, I believe, pretty good. There was some lot of amazing insights shared during these sessions that I cannot cover in this video, but you can definitely check that out. Last but definitely not the least, probably my favorite, were the hallway tracks. So it was more like a, you know, a hangout session sort of thing on Zoom. Like example, even though we were talking about our favorite talks that we were attending, what our key takeaways were, and sharing if any talks were, you know, we particularly found even more interesting than, you know, that we wanted to share, like, hey, you can attend this, you should check out this, or did you see that talk. But it was also about like the fun that we were having. Like, I remember we were talking about vegetables and the things that are like, you know, growing in various parts of the world and countries, and what people are eating, for example. We're sharing keyboards, and if you saw like the pop street, we shared the keyboards, and we ended up discussing regarding mechanical keyboards and switches and all these things. DIMS and other contributors in the CNCF organization, they shared their you know, stories about how they got started. And I believe Priyanka also joined the last, you know, the hallway track, and I saw 100 plus people and a lot of students over there as well who joined. And yeah, it was just great interacting with everyone. Hallway tracks were amazing. Yeah, as close like as we can. I know, like, it's been hard for everyone, the pandemic and the limitations that we have had with virtual platforms, but I believe the hallway tracks were a really huge success. And even like with the previous KubeCons, just meeting people like during these sessions has been the highlight, at least for me, for virtual events. Now, as a wrap up, I just want to share that the recordings are available on YouTube on the CNCF channel. So any talk or keynote you want to check out, you can. And I'm really looking forward to KubeCon NA. I truly believe it's going to be even bigger, with even more young people and beginners joining this time. I will, you know, try my best. We all will try our best, and we all will, like, you know, share about the great work that CNCF does. And I just want to thank Cloud Native Computing Foundation for all the work that they are doing to make the community more inclusive. And yeah, that was pretty much about it. KubeCon EU 2021 from a student's point of view. So I'm still a junior right now. I'm going to be graduating next year. But the amount of experience that I have gotten from these open source communities has been truly, you know, tremendous. And I cannot thank everyone enough for, you know, everything that they are doing for the community and the platform that they are providing for people to grow, learn, and network and share. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Have a great day. Bye.